Hi and welcome to this new showing of my collection video. I lost track of which number videos this one is, but it is a new one and one in a small shelves category. And this one is not a specific for one army, and normally I have shelf filled with one army style models and figures, but this one is a bit of everything. Quick look at figures, all sticker pack Brickmanias. Only thing I did is painted little shoes on them, and one ugly figure in the back over there, and these two I thought it were Polish with painted rifles. Those stickers were from the Blitzkrieg book from Brickmania, just like these three models. But let's look at the models. I removed the fix, and so we can take a better look at those models. So this first one is a Renault UE with attached on top of it a PAC 36. This design is made by Todd Eller, aka Florida Shooter, but I did understand that it was heavily inspired by some other builder, and I can't remember his name. So unfortunately this one will never be a tutorial video, but nevertheless I'm very happy having it in my collection. I think it's a really nice little build. It doesn't have any spectacular features at all, but I really like this small kind of artillery tractors, what this is actually meant to be. I really like these little two-person track vehicles. I don't know why, but I really like them. So I'm really happy to having this one. And then the next one, I have to take a look at this book because it's from the Blitzkrieg book, and this one is the Belgium T13B3. It should have been in dark tan, but me having a lot of dark blues gray bricks, I thought I'd make it in dark blues gray. This is designed, of course, then by Brickmania. That's a rotating turret. I don't know if this is really a turret, because the soldiers would be in here. It's some kind of tank destroyer, I think, and it turns around, but I'm not sure if you call it a turret, if that's the correct name. If you know the correct name, please tell me in the comments. Otherwise, not much features on this one, but once again, just like that one, I really like small little tracked vehicles, so I really like this one too. I'm happy to have this one, little Belgian one, happy with it. This one, I do know, it's the M39 Panzerwagen. I can say that one right in Dutch, Panzerwagen. More Dutch than that I can't say. Probably I'm pronouncing with a really, really bad Easter Dutch accent, but I don't care. Finally, I can say something in Dutch in my videos, because this is a Dutch vehicle. The Dutch army didn't have too much armed vehicles or tanks of whatsoever. I think read somewhere they had Renault FT tanks, only one or two, but a couple of these, not much. I think less than 10 or something. But I really like Brickmania have made this one. They also put it in a book. So yes, I really am happy to have a Dutch vehicle, World War II vehicle, because there are not much Dutch vehicles at all in history. So in real life history. So having one in Lego is very cool. What can I say? A little bit suspension working over here. Other features is, can remember, no, there's no opening hatch. There's a elevating gun. That's about it. That's all the features about this one. But still, very happy having this one. Just because it's Dutch, to be honest. And the last vehicle on this shelf is... isn't a vehicle, it's a gun, of course. And this one is also from the book. And this is the Earhart 7.5 World War II Norwegian cannon. I did understand that reading history books that the Germans used this gun, used this one, and actually used this one, and of course, because there's a pack on top of it, used this one. Germany relied big time on captured vehicles, tanks, and all kinds of war material from the countries they invade. So many stuff that is made by other countries, like the, for example, the 38T tank from Czechoslovakia, were used after capturing by Germany. And the same goes for this gun. This gun has no features at all. Just, yeah, because what would you push into it as a feature? But still, I like it. You can attach it to something, roll around with it. Yeah, just nice design. Really like it. Well, actually, that's for this shelf already. Not much to see on this shelf. Yeah, the figures, I don't think they are worth the effort of showing in detail. What I want to say extra is that just earlier this week I did a tutorial on this one. I didn't do it. I didn't have a tutorial video on this Florida Shooter 38T based self-propelled gun. It's the Grill in German. Florida Shooter, very cool design. There is a tutorial video. I'll put up a link over there. If you want to build this one, actually some people already sent me pictures of it on Instagram, so check out my Instagram if you want to see those. So yeah, I keep it for now on this shelf, and next week I will go to this shelf, one of my favorite shelves all time. What can I say to close down? Let's say, like all YouTubers say, like this video, give me a comment about what you think about the models. What do you think about this one? Tell me what you think about this one in dark blue gray or dark tan. Which one looks better? I think dark tan looks better, but I had only dark blue gray tape. So, okay. Leave a comment, leave a like, and please subscribe. I really am in need of more subscribers and viewers. So please subscribe, hit the bell, so you will know when to watch the next video. Thank you for watching this one, and hope to see you in the next video. Bye.